गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ प्योर सब्सटेंसेस. वी विल स्टार्ट द सैचुरेटेड वेपर एंड सुपरहीटेड वेपर. व्हेन योर लिक्विड चेंजेस इट्स फेस इनटू द गैसियस और यू कैन सी वेपर फॉर्म, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड सैचुरेटेड वेपर. एंड इफ यू फर्दर हीट, सो दैट विल बिकम सुपरहीटेड वेपर. सो वंस बॉइलिंग स्टार्ट्स, द टेम्परेचर स्टॉप्स राइजिंग until the liquid is completely vaporized. So during boiling, the temperature won't increase. What will happen? Your liquid starts to change its phase. That is, temperature will remain constant during the entire phase change process if the pressure is held constant. But the pressure has to be constant. Means whatever the pressure here, this is the here your boiling had started. You can see in this diagram, boiling had started, the liquid converted to vapor here, it is called saturated vapor, but pressure is 1 atmosphere, this has to be constant. This can be easily verified by placing a thermometer into the boiling pure water on top of stove at sea level when your pressure is 1 atmospheric. You can check on a boiled container where water is boiling. That will show 100 degrees Celsius. The thermometer always read 100 degrees Celsius if the pan is uncovered or covered with a light lid. During a boiling process, the only change we'll observe is a large increase in volume and a steady decline in liquid level as a result of more liquid turning to vapor. So you can see here in this diagram, if you compare with this diagram where you had pure liquid, here you had liquid. But level of liquid will decrease because some amount of liquid has converted into vapor. Midway about the vaporization line, state 3, so this is your midway, means complete liquid has not converted to vapor, part of the liquid has converted into vapor. The cylinder contains equal amounts of liquid and vapor, equal amounts of liquid as well as vapor. As we continue transferring heat, the vaporization process continues until the last drop of liquid is vaporized. So if further heat, what will actually happen? At the last, when you heat, the whole liquid will convert into steam. So this is your vapor here. So whatever liquid here, it is completely converted into saturated vapor. So at the end of the process, you will get vapor at 1 atmosphere and 100 degrees Celsius. So complete liquid has changed into vapor. Any heat loss from this vapor will cause some of vapor to condense. A vapor that is about to condense is called saturated vapor. You can see in this diagram. Now we had just came to a position where your complete liquid is converted to vapor. So this is completely vapor. If there is any heat loss from this vapor, somehow this vapor will condense and it will again convert back into start into liquid form. Therefore state 4 is called saturated vapor state. So this state where you had complete vapor, just vapor has formed, so this state is called saturated state. Since the liquid and vapor phase coexist in equilibrium at these states, so this is called saturated liquid vapor mixture also. Since those liquid and vapor coexist, so between two, this state 2 and between state 4, this state 4, this is called saturated liquid vapor mixture, because in between this state we had, here you had part of saturated vapor and part is your saturated liquid. So this state is called your saturated liquid vapor state. Once the phase change process is completed, we are back to single phase region. Now here we again had a single phase here. Here we had solid, you can say liquid phase of the water. Here we had two phases, gaseous phase, vapor phase as well as the liquid phase. Here we again enter into a single phase region, which is only vapor phase. If you transfer further heat, then both the temperature and specific volume increase. At state 5, the temperature of vapor is, let's say, 306 Celsius. And if water transfers some heat from the vapor, the temperature may drop somewhat, but no condensation will occur. as long as temperature remains above 100 degrees Celsius. So now talk about this state 5. If more heat is transferred, the temperature of vapor start to rise. It is called superheated vapor. So if you further heat this vapor here at 100 degrees Celsius, they will start to expand. The volume will start to expand, their volume will increase. So suppose you had heated vapor from 100 degrees to 300 degrees Celsius, so their volume will increase, volume of vapor will increase, but the phase remains same, that is vapor phase. So this vapor which are at 300 degrees Celsius, these are called superheated vapor. If these vapor will lose heat, they won't convert into liquid form. Their temperature will just get decrease. So this is called superheated vapor. A vapor that is not about to condense, not a saturated vapor, is called a superheated vapor. Therefore, water at state 5 is a superheated vapor. This constant pressure phase change process is illustrated on TV diagram. So this whole process is shown on temperature volume diagram. You can see here. So starting point is here. When your water is at 20 degrees Celsius, it is in liquid form. You start supplying heat, its temperature start to rise, its temperature will rise up to 2 point only temperature will rise, and from 1 to 2 your water will remain as compressed liquid. Means from 1 to 2 phase does not change, only temperature will rise. At 2 point when the temperature is 100 degrees Celsius and you had liquid phase, if you further supply heat, now from 2 to 3 or 2 to 4, we are further supplying heat to this liquid. Liquid start to change into vapor. Part of liquid will convert into vapor. At 3 point, you have both the part is liquid form, part is in the vapor form. So this mixture at 3 is called saturated mixture. Means part is the liquid form, part is in vapor form, but temperature remains 100 till 4. Means from 2 to 4, this is your phase change process in which temperature remains constant, only liquid is started converting into vapor. At 4 point, you had complete vapors. Temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. So this 4 point, this is your fourth state where you had complete vapor. Temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. So at 4 point, you had complete vapors. Now if you further heat, what will happen from 4 to 5? So this is your fifth state where your pressure is 1 atmosphere, temperature is 300 degrees Celsius. So pressure is fixed, so taken as 1 atmosphere. Now this is at 5 where your steam is at 300 degrees temperature and pressure of 1 atmospheric. So from 4 to 5, so conversion of this vapor at 100 degrees Celsius to 300 degrees Celsius, this is called superheated vapor. So from 4 to 5, this region where your vapor is in superheated state is called superheated vapor. So this is your temperature volume diagram here. So the entire process prescribed here is reversed by cooling the water while maintaining the pressure at the same value. The water will go back to state 1, retracing the same path, and in doing so, the amount of heat released will exactly match the amount of heat added during the heat process. So you can see here, from 1 to state 5, whatever heat we had transferred through this arrangement, whatever heat will transfer from 1 to 5, if you reverse this path, if we go in direction from 5 to 4, that is 300 to 100 degrees Celsius, then 4 to 3, 3 to 2, and 2 to 1. So whatever heat we are supplying here, the same amount of heat we can retrieve from this process. So this process is, you can say, reversible process. It can be reversed and it will follow the same path. So in our daily life, water implies liquid vapor and steam implies water vapor. So in normal cases, we use water, liquid water, and for superheated, or you can say this superheated vapor, we consider it as steam. So both water and steam usually mean only one thing, that is H2O, but both has the same composition, chemical formula, that is H2O. In thermodynamics, we are more concerned with only the this chemical formula. Now we'll start with the topic, that is saturation temperature and saturation pressure. Means the point at which your water will convert to vapor. It is probably come as no surprise to you that water start to boil at 100 degrees Celsius, strictly speaking. The statement water boils at 100 degrees Celsius is incorrect. The correct statement is water boils at 100 degrees Celsius at 1 atmosphere pressure. Means the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius if the atmosphere pressure is 1 atmosphere. Otherwise it will change. The only reason water started boiling at 100 degrees Celsius was because normally we have the atmosphere pressure which is 1 atmospheric. If the pressure inside the cylinder were raised to say 5 atmospheric, or you can say 500 kilopascal by adding weights on the top of the piston, water would start boiling at 151 degrees Celsius. If you put a weight here and then you supply heat, due to the weight, the pressure within the cylinder will increase. Say it is 5 atmospheric, then water won't boil at 100 degrees Celsius, it will boil at 151 degrees Celsius. So the temperature at which water starts boiling depends on pressure. Therefore, if the pressure is fixed, so the boiling temperature. The temperature at which pure substance changes phase is called saturation temperature. And the pressure at which pure substance changes phase is called saturation pressure. So means that we'll discuss in the diagram. So these pressure and temperature are interrelated. So at, you can say, 1 bar, which is here, that 100 kilopascal, your water boil at almost 100 degrees Celsius. When you increase the pressure, you can say saturation pressure will increase, suppose 200. So 200 kilopascal, water will boil at 125 degrees Celsius. At 400 kilopascal, water will boil at 145 degrees Celsius. And almost at 500 kilopascal, water is boiled at 150 degrees Celsius. You can see in this table, that is saturation pressure of water at various temperature. So this is for 1 atmosphere pressure, water boils at 100. If the pressure increase to 476, water will boil at 150. And if pressure is further increased to almost 15 bar, water will boil at 200 degrees Celsius. So if pressure increases, saturation pressure increases, the boiling point of water will increase. So if saturation pressure is say 8588, the water will boil at 300 degrees Celsius. It takes a large amount of energy to melt a solid or vaporize a liquid. The amount of energy absorbed or released during a phase change process is called latent heat. Means this energy from 2 to 3 or 2 to 4 during which your water is changing phase from liquid to vapor, this heat is called latent heat. During this process, the temperature remains constant. So heat, whatever heat we are supplying, that is consumed in changing the phase from liquid to vapor. So this heat is a function of pressure also. If the pressure is 1 atmospheric, this heat from 2 to 4 is different. If pressure is space 2 atmospheric, this latent heat from 2 to 4 will be higher. At 1 atmosphere pressure, the latent heat of fusion of water is 333 kilojoule per kilogram, and latent heat of vaporization is 2256. Means this at 1 atmosphere pressure, the heat supplied from 2 to 4 is 2256. But if this pressure, atmosphere pressure increases, the heat supplied from to change liquid to vapor will increase. Also, you can see the example of a pressure cooker. Why we use pressure cooker? In the pressure cooker is a closed container. So operating atmosphere, pressure in the pressure cooker is 3 atmospheric. So it means water in the pressure cooker won't boil at 100 degrees Celsius. It will boil at 134 degrees Celsius. So the whatever the food is submerged into the pressure cooker water, it will take heat from the water without water get boiled. So it is easy to cook the food in pressure cooker. Otherwise, if you cook the food at atmosphere pressure, water will boil at 100 degrees Celsius, leaving food in the pan, and so it is better to cook food with the help of pressure cooker. At mountain, it is difficult to cook the food because of lower atmosphere pressure and lower boiling point of water. So Like this video, subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.